Hi, good afternoon, everyone.
大家下午好，新年快乐。
It's very good to see everyone here.
很开心看到大家。
This is a very special weekend.
这是一个很特别的周末。
Of course, it's the start of the new year.
当然是一年来的第一个周末。
Last night, we also had a very beautiful service here at TC.
昨天晚上呢，我们在这个处爱中心这边也有一个很特别的一个聚会。
Because being the first weekend of the year, we also dedicated all the staff of Touch Community Services and Touch International.
因为每一年的年头呢的第一个周末，我们都会为着处爱社会服务还有处爱国际事工的同工们。做一个献礼。
And we believe they've been a tremendous blessing to Singapore and the nations around, and we're so thankful for them.
我们相信这两个机构呢是全新加坡还有世界各国很大的祝福，所以我们感恩。
The other reason why it's a special weekend.
另外一个原因为什么这个周末那么特别呢
？It's because at this first weekend of the year, I always like to share what is God's direction for the season ahead.
就是因为每次到了年头第一个周末呢，我都会分享上帝赐给我们的这个新的方向，而我就要分享这一年下来方向是什么。
Now before I jump into what is it exactly?
在我分享之前呢
I just want to share with you something. Maybe some of us have forgotten about this.
其实先跟大家分享一下，可能我们已经忘记了。
But if you remember last time in the earlier days of FCBC,
在我们教会在前几年的时候呢，早期的时候
，we would have yearly themes.
我们每一年都有不一样的主题。
So it's a year of this, a year of that.
所以我们每次都会有什么丰盛的一年了，什么什么的一年的一个主题。
But a few years ago, I changed that.
几年前呢，我就把它给改变了。
Because sometimes I find it's very limiting to contain it within one year.
如果我们每一年都有一个很特意的一个主题呢，就把它给限制住了。
And so sometimes I find that God works in a season.
所以有时候我是发现到啊，上帝呢带领我们呢，不是一年带一年的，而是一个季节接着一个季节。
It could be, that season could be 1 year.
那个季节可能是一年。
It could be 2 years or 3 years or 5 years.
可能是两三或者五年。
So I've been focusing a lot more on seasons.
所以呢，我反而呢就寻求主了，我们专注在。
So I want to take a quick recap on what was this last season for us in this past 2 years.
所以让我们回顾一下这两年来上帝带领我们进入什么样的季节。
At the start of 2018, the Lord led us into what I call a season of cultivation.
在2018年开头的时候呢，上帝带领我们进入了培育的季节。
This season of cultivation was about growing deep and growing strong in God.
当时呢，这个培育的季节呢，就带领了我们要学习如何向下扎根，向上成长。
Now, if you see the design here,
如果你看到这个设计啊
you see leaves, you see
你看见叶子
trees and all that.
你看见树什么的
Somehow, when God gave me this word, He kept showing me plants.
当上帝给了我这个季节的主题的时候呢，他一直让我看到了很多花草树木
And I think it's probably because of this promise I've been holding on.
而是因为我一直有着一直紧抓住这个应许。
Zechariah chapter 8 verse 12，
就是在撒迦利亚书第八章第十二节告诉我们，因为他们必平安撒种，葡萄树必结果，地土必有出产，天也必降甘露。我要使这剩余的民享受这一切的福。
I believe God is saying that as we are faithful to Him, He will bring a grand harvest.
我深信，当我们信实于上帝的时候呢，他会为我们带来一个很大的收割。
And so God gave me the word cultivation.
所以呢，上帝就给了我这个字，这个字叫做培育。
Because cultivation is actually a word that is very much related to growing plants.
其实培育呢，很多时候呢是用来是跟栽种这个字是有关联的。
其实 one thing I taught during this season.
在之前这个季节，我一直教导的呢。
Was that cultivation is actually the process of preparing ground.
就是培育其实是在预备着这块土地可以去栽种。
If you want to grow a plant,
如果你要栽种一棵树或者植物的话
，Well, you need a seed.
你需要种子。
The seed needs to have water.
那个种子呢是需要有水。
The seed needs sunlight as well.
需要有阳光。
But one thing people forget.
可是人通常会忘记了一件事。
Is that if the ground is not good,
就是如果这片土地呀、没有去松土的话
，the seed will not grow well.
那个土不好的话呢，这个种子不会好好成长。
You can have the best seed specimen in the world.
你可以有世界上最配的最好的种子。
You can give it all the water and all the sunlight it needs.
你可以就是给它浇花，给它晒太阳。
But if it's in bad ground.
可是如果它的土地是不好的话呢
it will not grow well.
它是不会好好成长的。
That's why I said we must grow deep and grow strong.
所以我就说了，我们需要向下扎根，向上成长。
You see, let's just imagine with me for a moment.
你们就陪我试想一下。
Let's say I've got a tree, there's a big tree here.
打个比方说，我有一棵大树。
Let's say there's a tree that's maybe 4 stories high.
4层楼高的大树。
That's a very tall tree.
就是一棵老树了，其实。
But if the roots are very shallow.
可是如果它的根呢、 扎的不是很深的话，如果它的根没有扎的特别深在土地里的话，它不是一棵很牢固的树。
A strong wind, a strong storm will cause the entire tree to topple.
大风暴就会把它给吹倒。
So how does it apply to us as a church?
那我们身为教会呢，应该如何应用这个学习到的功课呢
？Two years ago, I said this.
两年前我说过。
Lord, I believe you want us to grow.
主啊，我相信你要我们成长。
But there's no point in us growing so tall above the surface if our roots are not deep.
如果我们长到这个地面上长得很高的话，可是我们然而没有扎根的好的话，也没有用。
So this church must cultivate a culture and an environment that is ready for growth.
所以我们教会必须培育出一个文化、一个环境，好让我们可以扎根。
And so in this season of cultivation,
所以在这个培育的季节里面呢
we've been shaping the culture again.
我们一直在树立着教会的文化。
We've been coming back to this focus on missions.
我们回到我们最起初所认识所要做的就是宣教。
We've been talking about the basics of evangelism again.
我们说到传福音的那个最基础的东西。
We've been challenging ourselves to give more to the Lord.
我们挑战大家，我们要奉献更多给主。
We're in the process of introducing new ministries so that we can serve the church in this time.
我们正在准备着开办新的一些事工，好让我们更好的服侍教会的会友。
We are doing all these things so that this church can be deeply rooted.
我们做了很多，好让我们的教会能够稳稳的扎根。
And this cultivation will carry on.
这个培育的季节不会结束。
Cultivation is not something that you do one off.
培育并不是一次性或者是一夜之间做的。
It is a continual process.
是一个一直在进行着的过程。
But as we enter into this time, into 2020.
可是呢，当我们进入2020年的时候呢
，I believe God wants to give us a directed focus.
我相信上帝要给我们一个有方向的一个焦点。
I'm going to share with you what this theme is.
我要跟大家分享这个主题了。
But I'm going to tell you the story of how I got there.
可是我要跟大家分享我是怎么样得到这个主题的这个名字的。
See, this year we're 2020.
今年是2020了。
It's a new year.
是新的一年
It's a new decade.
新就是新的一个转十年的一个季节了
And it's also a new season.
也是一个新的季节
2020 is the first time that FCBC is starting with a new senior pastor.
2020年呢也是我们 FCBC 坚信进信会就是一开年就有新的主任牧师了
Last August I was installed as a senior pastor.
去年八月呢我按立为我们教会的主任牧师
A few months before that I was praying and asking God what is a word you have for me?
在被按立之前的前几个月我就寻求主说主啊你有什么话语要赐给我的
I said God when my dad started this church when you caused him to start this church you gave him a very specific word in Haggai 2
就是当时呢当我的父亲他创办教会的时候上帝给了他一个很确定的一个话语就是在哈该书第二章
And that word is that the glory of this house shall be greater than the glory of the former and in this house there shall be peace
就是那段话语就是哈该书第二章第九节告诉我们这殿后来的荣耀必大过先前的荣耀在这个地方我必赐平安
Now, I think this word will always be for us.
我觉得这段哈该书的话语呢，一直下去都是属于我们的。
But I say, God, that is the word you gave to my dad.
可是我说主啊，这段话语是你赐给我父亲的。
I say, God, I want a word for myself.
可是主啊，我要你赐一段话语给我。
A word for me and this.And the church as we go into this new season.
当我们进入新的季节，我求主，你赐给我一段话语，给我也给我们的教会。
And God answered my prayer. He gave me a word.
而上帝就给了我一段话语了。
That word is found in Ephesians chapter 3 verses 20 to 21.
这段话语呢，就在以弗所书第三章第二十节到二十一节。神能照着运行在我们心里的大力，充充足足的成就一切，超过我们所求所想的。但愿他在教会中，并在基督耶稣里得着荣耀，直到世世代代，永永远远。Amen.
I believe this word.
我非常深信这段话语。
That we're going to come into a time we're going to see God doing abundantly more than we've seen before.
我们会看见上帝充充足足的成就一切。
And as I spend time praying and meditating over this passage,
而当我在祷告为着这段话语，祷告上帝要告诉我什么的时候
，One thing kept ringing in my head.
有一段话呢，就一直会。就牢牢地锁在我的脑海里。
We must go beyond.
我们一定要超越。
That's what God kept saying, we must go beyond.
在上帝就一直跟我说我们要超越。
We must grow beyond any kind of barriers.
我们要成长，我们要超越任何的一些阻碍。
We must grow beyond our weaknesses.
我们要超越所有的软弱。
We must grow beyond our fears.
我们要超越我们的惧怕。
Go beyond our expectations.
我们要超越我们的期盼。
And so on and so forth.
彼此类推。
God is saying it's time to go beyond.
上帝说是时候要超越了，要超越所有了。
Don't just remain and settle where you are. Go beyond.
不要安于现状，你要超越。
But I kept thinking.
那我就想了。
This doesn't sound nice.
这听起来没有什么押韵呐。
You know, didn't have quite a catch to it.
就听起来就不容易记。
Of course, I always think in English lah.
当然，宝莱牧师是用英文来思考的。
So I kept saying, well, in English, well, go beyond doesn't sound very nice.
如果英文说要超越，听起来好像没有什么押韵。
In for those who understand English, season or year of going beyond doesn't sound very nice.
就是超越的季节，听起来好奇怪。
So I prayed.
所以就祷告了。
And God gave me a phrase.
上帝就给了我一段词。
Well, it's an English phrase that there's no equivalent in Mandarin.
其实中文呢是没有。一个相对的一个很准确的翻译的。
But God gave me a line from a movie.
可是上帝呢就给了我一段话是来自一部电影的。
And that is our theme for this season.
而这个电影里面的这段话就是我们的主题了。
So we've got a Chinese version of it, of course, but those who know who have watched this movie in English, you will know what I'm talking
about. 曾经看过这部电影的呢，然后而理解到它的英文的吗？是会知道这段话的。
Okay, so this is the theme.
所以这主题就是叫做
The theme is to infinity and beyond.
英文名就是 to infinity and beyond. 你们知道是哪一部电影的吗？
Toy Story 玩具故事。
不是啦，玩具总动员。
Yeah, Toy Story. So, to infinity and beyond.
就是这英文字叫做 to infinity and beyond.
And in Mandarin, 我们叫做要超越极限。
超越极限就是我们今年的主题。
That is the theme for this season ahead.
这就是我们今年来的这个主题了。
That we're going to go beyond all limits.
我们要超越所有的极限。
Because that is what Ephesians 3:20 and 21 is about.
因为以弗所书第三章第二十节到二十一节就是要教导我们要去超越极限。
It says that God can do.Exceeding abundantly more.
他这里讲着上帝是可以能够丰丰富富成就一切，超过我们所求所想的。
That, look at those two words, 超过。
超过这两个字。
So that's why we can go beyond all these limits.
所以我们的确是可以超过、超越这所有的这些限制。
What does it mean to have no limits?
在无限的这个环境里面是什么意思呢
？It means that we must rise up and have faith.
也就是说，我们必须兴起来要有信心。
Faith that says that there's no opposition too strong.
就是说，没有任何的仇敌、没有任何的阻挡能够阻止我们。
There's no barrier too high.
没有任何的阻碍能够挡太高的阻碍。
No place that is too far.
没有太远的地方不能去。
No mountain that's too big.
没有太大的山不能攀。
No ocean that's too wide.
没有太宽阔的海不能游。
No challenge that is too big for us.
没有任何挑战是不能征服的。
See that is what means to have no limits.
所以我们就是说了，就是没有一个限制。
Okay, why don't you 跟你旁边的人说超越极限
？Why don't you 跟你旁边的人说超越极限
？See, I want to tell you that there's no limits.
的确是没有限制的。
Listen to me, there are no limits because we serve a limitless God.
听好，侍奉无限大能的神，让我们有无限可能的人生。
Right, I want to pause here for a moment.
我们停顿一下。
You know, all this sounds nice.
这些听起来都特别好听。Wow,
going beyond limits.
我们要超越极限，超越限制。
Wow, there are no limits.
是无限可能的。
They sound good.
听起来特别有押韵。
And it's a nice slogan. We come to church and we say, yeah, we chant it.
这口号说的真好，无限可能，无限。
But what happens when you really face limitations?
可是当你遇到真正的阻碍、真正的限制的时候，怎么办？
When you face difficulty, you face sickness, you face opposition.
人生的困难、有疾病的时候，有人阻挡你的时候。
We want to tell you that we're not here just to chant a few nice slogans.
我们来不只是为了单单在喊口号而已。
We're here to know that God is with us.
我们要知道神与我们同在。
And when God is with us, He will always enable you to go beyond.
当神与我们同在，他一定会赐给你那个能力，能够去超越。
So today the question I want to explore with us is this.
所以今天要问的这个问题就是
What is it that will enable us to go beyond?
到底是什么能使我们超越极限？
Two things I want to share with us.
我要分享两大要点。
Number one.
第一。
We have accessibility to God.
我们要知道神为我们打开大门。
And what that means is that He grants us power.
这也就是说我们能够亲近他，他就能够赐给我们能力。
See, what I mean by this is that all of us, we have access to God.
我要让大家知道的就是我们是都有那个可以亲近神的那个能力。
That God opens his doors, he invites us.
上帝打开他的大门，他邀请我们来亲近他。
He doesn't push us away.
他并没有把我们给推开。
And today I believe all of us need to understand this access that we have to God.
今天我们要知道我们是有那个权利，那个能力可以去亲近神的。
Sometimes I think we don't talk enough about the access that we have to God.
有时候呢，我们提的不够啊，我们说的不够，其实我们跟神是可以离得特别近的。
You see, we always like to focus on knowing God.
我们每次都说我们要认识神。
Nothing wrong with that, huh?
没错，这是对的。
But let me tell you something.
我还要告诉你。
There's a difference between knowing God.
认识神。
And having access to God.
还有能够亲近神是不一样的。
They're two very different things.
是两个非常不一样的东西。
So let me give you an example.
所以我给你一个例子吧。
Okay? I'm not here to 号练 anything, huh?
我不是要来号练的。
But can I tell you something, huh?
可是我要告诉你。
Do you know that I actually know the Queen of England?
你知道其实我是认识英国的英女王吗？
I know the Queen of, I know Queen Elizabeth.
我认识她。
I was actually there at the 60th at the Diamond Jubilee that year.
当年那个钻石的一个庆贺的时候，当时我在英国。
I went there. I was in celebration. I saw the exhibition and everything.
我参加了庆典，我也去了她的展览。
I actually know her.
我认识她。
But can I tell you something?
可是我要告诉你。
I don't have access to her.
可是我没办法亲近她。
I can know everything about her.
我可以知道她所有的一切。
I can be part of that celebration.
我也参加了那个庆典。
I can go and read about her online or in a museum.
我上网或者去博物馆，我都可以认识到她更多。
I can know everything about her.
我可以知道她所有的一切。
But I've got no access to her.
可是我没有办法去近距离跟她相处。
Today after I finish Chinese service,
今天华文聚会过了之后呢
，I can't pick up my phone and call her.
我不能够打电话给她。
Hey, Elizabeth, want to drink coffee?
Hey, 伊丽莎白，吃饭喝咖啡。
I can't do that. Why?
我不可以这样做。
Because I don't have access.
因为我没有她号码。
See, knowing is one thing.
认识是一回事。
Having access is another thing.
能够亲近，能够联系是另外一回事。
Same thing, you know.
同样的
Knowing God is one thing,
认识上帝是一回事
But realizing that you have access to God is a different
thing altogether. 可是你要知道你能够亲近他你能够跟他联系其实是另外一回事了
See, we talk so much about knowing God.
我们经常说到我们去认识上帝
Which is good, we should know God.
是很好的
know
我们一定要去认识他的话语
But sometimes we think that, wow, coming to church is like a museum.
可是我们觉得有时候来教会就好像来博物馆这样
you walk into an exhibition.
你走进了展览
And God is behind a glass panel.
然后上帝就在一个模式树立在后面
的 him,
你就是来观摩他
一下 paper,
然后你就读了一些资讯关于他的
But that's not all it is, you know?
可是上帝不仅仅是这样啊
God invites us into his presence
上帝邀请我们打开他大门进入他的同在
We have access to her, to him, we can get close to him
我们能够进入他的同在
We can encounter and experience
我们可以经历他我们可以体验到上帝的同在
Today we must understand we have access to God
所以今天我要让大家知道我们是的确能够进入他的同在的
Let's take a look again at Ephesians 3:20
我们看一下在以弗所书第三章第二十节上帝的能力运行在我们里面能够丰丰富富的成就一切超过我们所求所想的
Now I want to pause it for a moment
我们停顿一下
There's something very interesting here
你看到这段经文
This passage says that it has this word of it says that we can ask him
这个段经文告诉我们我们可以求他
Okay, this is not just, it's not just about begging him for something
不单单是真的是求他跪地求的一个东西
Making a presenting a request, talking to God, saying, "I want to ask for something."
而是在跟他对话，跟他说，我有一个要求，我要寻求。
You know, when you talk about this, it says it shows us that we have access. You know,
当你说你要去要求、去寻求、去求他的时候，也就是说，其实你是可以去到他的面前的。
See, this passage didn't just say that God is exceedingly abundantly powerful.
这段话语呢，这段经文并不是说上帝是超过我们的所能够想象的那个大能大力的。
So it doesn't just talk about his power.
他不只是说他的能力而已。
It says that he will do more. He has ability to do more than what you ask.
他说他能够丰丰富富成就一切，超过我们所求的。
So the fact that you can ask.
所以其实你是可以求他的。
Means you have access to him. You can have a relationship. You can ask him for something.
也就是说，其实你跟他是有一段关系，你可以去到他的面前，亲近他，去问他。
See, today we must come back to this of asking God.
今天我们要回到那个，我们要认知到我们是可以去寻求主的。
We can ask God, 不只是寻求，是要求，
要求、苦求、力求
，all kinds of 求啊，
求到完了。
Okay?
求助。
We can go to God and ask Him for things.
我们可以去到他的面前啊，跟他要东西，跟他要求。
So today I want to say this to the church.
所以今天我要跟教会说。
We need to ask big, you know.
我们必须要寻求更大的东西。
Dream big.
我们要有更大的梦想。
Ask God for greater things in our
life. 我们要更大的事情成就在我们生命里面。
Not for our own benefit.
不单单是为了自己的利益。
Not for our own glory.
不是为着自己的荣耀。
But to fulfill God's purpose.
而是为了完成上帝的大使命。
You know, I want to share with us about two different people in the Gospels.
我要跟大家分享圣经里面的两位人物。
Two men that were healed by Jesus.
被耶稣医治好的两个人。
Let's look at John chapter 5 verses 2 to 9.
我们看一下约翰福音第五章第二节到第九节。耶路撒冷靠近羊门的地方有一个水池，希伯来话叫比士大。池边有五条走廊，里面躺着瞎眼的、瘸腿的、瘫痪的等等许多病人，他们都在等候天使来搅动这个池水。水在动的时候呢，第一个下去的无论患什么病都会痊愈。那里有一个人病了38年，耶稣看他躺着，知道他病了很久，就问他，你想痊愈吗？第七节，那个人回答说，先生，水动的时候没有人把我放进水池里面，我要下去的时候别人总是先我一步。耶稣对他说，起来，拿起你的垫子走吧。那个人立刻痊愈了，拿起垫子开始行走。
Now, what happened here?
当时发生什么事呢？
There's this pool in this place called Bethesda.
在比士大这个地方呢，有一个水池。
Now this pool is interesting.
这个水池里面的水好厉害啊。
It tends to bubble.
是会起泡泡的。
It's clear water, but it bubbles.
是清水，可是可以冒泡。
And the belief of the people was this.
然后当时的人相信
that when it bubbles,
当它起泡的时候呢
an angel was actually stirring the water.
就是其实是有天使在搅动它。
Scripture actually records this. That's what they believe.
经文所记载的，他们所相信的。
So people believe that that water has healing powers.
所以他们当时以为这个是神仙水啊，喝了会好。
That's why people will be just lying all over the place around all sick people gather around.
所以当时所有的病人都会环绕着这个水，就躺在那边在等候着。
The moment it starts to bubble,
它在冒泡的那个水，他们。就冲进池里面，然后就会医治了。
So we read about this, and this man he said, "I cannot even make it to the pool."
然后这个人就跟耶稣说，我连去进到池里都没有办法去。
But in the end, Jesus heals him.
可是最后呢，怎么样呢？耶稣还是医治了他。
So this is the first person.
所以这是第一个人物啊。
Now let's look at another person that got healed by Jesus.
我们现在看第二个人物。
Mark chapter 10.
就是在马可福音第十章46节到52节。耶稣和门徒来到耶利哥，当耶稣和门徒及众人出城的时候，遇见一个瞎眼的乞丐坐在路旁，他在乞讨。他的名字叫巴迪买，是迪买的儿子。巴迪买一听到经过的是拿撒勒人耶稣，就喊道，大卫的后裔耶稣啊，可怜我吧。许多人都责备他，叫他不要吵，但他却更大声喊道，大卫的后裔，可怜我吧。49节，耶稣停下脚步，叫人带他过来。他们就对瞎子巴迪买说，好了，起来吧，他叫你呢。巴迪买丢下外衣，跳了起来，走到耶稣面前。耶稣问他，你要我为你做什么？瞎子就说，老师，我想能够看见。耶稣说，回去吧，你的信心救了你。那人就是巴迪买，他立刻得见光明，在路上跟从了耶稣。
So here we see two men.
我们看到两个人物
both got healed,
两个人都痊愈了
but very different circumstances.
可是他们的那个情况很不一样哈。
Okay, John, we talk about the first man already.
刚才说到第一个人
Okay, if you look at him,
如果你看着他
he was paralyzed.
他是瘫痪的
but Jesus went up to him.
可是耶稣去到他那里去
and Jesus said, would you like to be healed?
然后耶稣就问他你想得到你想痊愈吗
this man, what did he say?
这个人说什么呢
he said, I cannot be healed.
他说没办法痊愈啊
why?
为什么呢
He said, because I cannot make my way to the pool.
因为我没有办法自己带自己进入池里面。
And even if somebody helps me,
就算有人背着我把我抬进水池里面
By the time I get there, it's full of other people
到了水池里面就已经很多人啦。
So that's what he did.
所以他就这么说了。
Then you look at Bartimaeus.
然后去到巴迪买那边了。
Bartimaeus was a blind man.
巴迪买是瞎子。
He heard that Jesus was coming.
他听到拿撒勒人来了。
He initiated the contact with Jesus, you know.
是他主动的跟耶稣联系上了。
He asked Jesus.
他求耶稣了。
He said, "Son of David, help me."
他说大卫的后裔呀，救我。
Then what did the people say?
那些人说什么呢
？Shut up.
那些人说叫他不要吵。
Then what did he say?
然后他就说了什么呢？
He shouted even louder.
他更大声地喊，
Jesus, save me.
他说耶稣救我吧。
And then Jesus called him.
然后耶稣就叫他过来。
And Jesus asked him, what do you want me to do for you?
然后耶稣就问他，你要我为你做什么？
And Bartimaeus said, I want to see.
然后巴迪买他就说了，我想看见。
Hey, that's a big thing to ask for a blind man, you know.
一个瞎子可能瞎了很多年，要他能够说这句话，哇，这是一件大事。
He said, I want to see.
他说我要重见天日。
And Jesus healed him and said, your faith has healed you.
然后耶稣就治了他，然后说你的信心使你痊愈。
I want to share with you what the difference is between these two men.
我跟你分享这两个人物的区别在哪里。
The first one, the first man.
第一个瘫痪的。
How was he healed?
他是怎么样得医治的？我要告诉你。
He was healed by the grace of God.
他是被神的恩典所医治的。
Jesus took pity on him.
耶稣怜悯他。
Jesus healed him.
耶稣医治他。
Then you look at Bartimaeus.
然后我们去到巴迪买这边了。
These are not my words, 啊。
这是不是我的话哦。
These are Jesus' words.
这个是圣经里面耶稣所说的。耶稣说什么呢？
Your faith has
healed you. 你的信心医治了你。
Very different.
很不一样。
That first man,
第一个人,
when Jesus asked, "Do you want to be healed?"
当耶稣问他，你要痊愈吗？
He said, "I cannot."
那个人说没办法。
And what did he proceed to do?
然后接着做什么呢？
He made excuses.
他就找了很多借口。
Why he cannot be healed?
为什么他不能得医治？
I can't make it to the water.
哎，我去不到水池。
Even if I get there, other people.
我去到那边，我都输给别人了。
He made an excuse.
他就找尽了借口。
But what about Bartimaeus?
巴迪买呢？
Bartimaeus made an effort.
巴迪买他是尽心尽力了。
He heard Jesus coming.
他听说耶稣要过来。他就喊得越喊越大声，他呼求耶稣。
And when people ask him shut up, he yelled.
当有人叫他点的时候，他还更大声的喊。
And when Jesus said, "What can I do for you?"
当耶稣问我能为你做什么吗
？Bartimaeus asked, "I want to see."
巴迪买说了，我要看见。
And Jesus healed him and said, "Your faith has healed you."
耶稣就医治了他，然后就告诉他，你的信心救了你。
Hey, these are very two very interesting accounts, you know.
这两个故事的记载是非常非常重要的。
I want to be like Bartimaeus, you know.
我希望我不是那个瘫痪的人的态度，我有的是巴迪买的态度。
I want to hear God say this to me one day, you know.
我有一天，我希望耶稣会跟我说
，Daniel, your faith is what gave you that breakthrough.
宝亮啊，你的信心使你有突破了。
Your faith has set you free.
你的信心使你得自由了。
Your faith has healed you.
你的信心救了你了。
Your faith has caused you to go beyond limits.
你的信心帮助你超越极限了。
I want to hear that.
我要听到上帝这样跟我说。
I want to be like Bartimaeus. I want to dare to ask.
我要像巴迪买这样子，我要勇于去求去问。
Today I want to ask us, have we been asking God?
今天我要问大家，我们有问有求，我们敢去求上帝吗？
You know, one thing that has defined our church.
有一件事情呢，的确是让我们的教会跟其他教会不一样。
Is that we are people who dare to ask.
就是我们勇敢去求神。
Many years ago, my dad wrote a book.
很多年前呢，我的父亲呢写了一本书。
And it was an account of his own journey in the ministry and everything.
也就是他自己在事工里面，在服侍上帝的路程上的一个记载。
It was a small book.
这本书不是很厚。
But I don't know if you recall what was the title of that book.
不知道你记不记得当时他的那个书名叫什么
？The title was "Give Me the Multitudes."
当时的书名叫做《赐我万民》。
Hey, that right there is asking God, you know.
哇，这段话，这个书名基本上就是在寻求主，跟主要东西了。
Asking God for something big.
跟上帝要求啊，能够有伟大的事情。
And the thing is, have we been asking God?
我们有寻求主吗？我们去要求主吗？
I remember just this past week, I was having breakfast with Pastor Eugene Xiao.
啊，这个星期以来呢，我跟萧树庆牧师啊，我们去吃早餐了。
And I was just talking to him about my journey when I was a youth.
然后在跟他聊的时候，就聊了一下我在青少年的时候呢，我的一些心路历程。
And you know, I remember at that point in time, I was challenged by the G12 vision.
我记得当时呢，那个 G12 的意象啊，真的是给我下了一个挑战。
I said, God, I want to find my 12.
那时我就记得我说了，我说上帝啊，我要找到我的十二。
Now I was in polytechnic at that point.
当时我还在读理工学院。
And but I still continue to go back to my secondary school to serve in my scout unit there.
可是我还记得当时呢，我经常回去我的中学去那个童子军那边去服侍。
So I remember saying, "I got on to find my 12."
我记得我跟上帝说过，主啊，我要找到我的十二门徒。
And I remember I actually asked God for this.
我记得我还 我还求主要这个东西。
I say, God, I would like to find my 12 in 12 weeks.
我说主啊，我祷告我在十二个星期里面找到我的十二门徒。
I say, God, I'm going to believe that I'm going to invite people to church, and for 12 weeks, every weekend, someone will come to know you.
我要祷告主啊，我每一个星期我都会邀请人去教会，而接下来十二个礼拜，每一个礼拜都会有人啊、来教会。
So I invited people.
所以我就开始邀请人了。
And for 12 weeks,
然后连续十二个星期我祷告。
I ask God.
我求主。
And for 12 weeks,
连续
one person came to church.
十二个星期至少会有一个人啊、接受我的邀请。
And every weekend, one person gave their life to Christ.
而每一个周末，十二个周末都会有人信主。
So after 12 weeks, I had my first cell group.
所以呢，十二周之后呢，我就有第一个小组的聚会。
And but after that.
过后呢
I said, God, there must be more.
我说主啊，但应该不只是这样吧。
I said, God, I believe that you placed me in this scout unit for a reason.
我说主啊，我相信你带我去到这个童子军是有你的旨意的。
I believe one day I can see all of them being transformed by you.
我相信有一天整个童子军的这个团队会被你转化。
So I said, God, I want more.
所以我就跟主说，主啊，我要更多。
And then God gave me this idea.
而上帝给了我一个主意。
Because I did a lot of leadership training with them.
因为我就帮他们做了很多。一些领袖培训的东西。
Somebody gave me a book.
有人送了我一本书。
This book was entitled 52 Leadership Principles by taught by the life of Jesus.
然后呢，这本书呢就是五十二大领袖的原则是透过耶稣的生命而教导出来的。
So it's meant to go through one week, one lesson per week, one lah.
五十二个大原则就是每一个礼拜你都要学习一个原则了。
So I took that book.
我就拿了那本书。
I say, what if I teach them on leadership through this book?
我就说，如果我拿着这本书去教导童子军里面的人一些领袖的一些原则。
So I remember I created a course.
然后我就记得了，我制造了一个课程。
I wrote consent forms.
我就写了一个同意书。
I asked them to bring back for their parents.
我就把那个同意书印了，然后叫每个同学、每个学生带回家。
In that form, I wrote to their parents.
在同意书里面，我就写了给那些家长写了一封信。
I said I'm going to be teaching them from the Bible.
我说我即将会从圣经里面呢教导。
But my focus is on teaching them leadership principles.
可是我的焦点是要教导一些领袖的原则。
And I said, after all, as a Christian school, our beliefs are based on this.
因为当时呢，我们的学校是一个基督教的学校，我们要教导一些基督教的原则。
So I asked them to go and let their parents sign.
所以我就给了这些学生们，将带回家叫家长签名。
When I collected back the consent forms,
当我收回这些同意书的时候，九十张
，90 of them responded.
九十个学生要参加这个课程，不是全部都是基督徒的。
Their parents say, "Come, go and learn, go and learn."
非信徒的家长们都说，去学，去学，去学习吧。
And then, why was I doing all this?
为什么我做那么多呢
？Because I was asking God for more.
因为我在寻求主，我说主啊，我要更多。
I said, God, I believe there's a reason why I'm here.
我说主啊，你差我到童子军，一定有你的旨意。
I'm not in this place of influence or authority just for fun, one.
我并不是没有理由在一个有影响力的一个位置上的。
So God, use me. I want to be used.
所以上帝啊，求你大大使用我，我要你使用我。
And I saw that happening.
然后我就看见了九十个学生。
And I know I'm not the only one in FCBC with a story like that.
而我知道在我们教会里面，我不是唯一的一个有这样的故事分享。
Many of you here, you have similar stories.
你们也有很多这样的经历的。
But for I dare say this.
可是我敢说
，Many of you, you have that story.
你有那个故事
，because you ask God.
因为你求过神。
You had asked God for a dream.
你求上帝赐给你一个梦想。
You had said, God, I want to believe that my whole office can be changed.
你祷告过，你说主啊，我要相信我整个办公室都会得救。
God, I want to ask you to use me to change my whole school.
我祷告你会使用我来转化，来改变我的学校。
We dare to ask.
我们敢于寻求。
And today we must dare to ask God again.
而今天我们要敢于再次的去寻求主。
And you can ask God.
而你可以寻求主，你可以问他。
Because He is accessible.
因为呢，上帝打开他的大门，我们是可以来到他前面的，他的面前的。
He grants us His power.
他赐给我们他的能力。
And He works through us.
而他透过我们行大事。
So today is the first thing I want to share.
所以今天呢，我要跟大家分享第一件事。
What is it that will enable us to go beyond?
是什么会使我们能够超越极限呢
？Firstly, number one is our accessibility to God.
第一就是因为神他打开了大门。
And He gives us power.
他赐给我们能力。
We can access, we can reach out to that power.
我们可以得着那个能力，只要伸出手就有了。
But it's the second thing that I want to share today.
可是有第二个要点要跟大家分享的。
We also have authority from God.
我们也是有神所赋予的权柄。
He gives us position.
他赐给我们身份。
God has positioned each and every one of us as His children, and as His children, we have authority.
上帝赐给我们的身份就是他的儿女，而身为他的儿女，我们有权柄。
See, today I'm talking about going beyond.
今天呢，我们要分享的什么呢？就是要超越极限嘛。
Very often we don't go beyond because we focus on some and on the wrong things.
很多时候我们无法超越极限，因为我们的焦点放在错的地方了。
Let me explain that.
我解释一下。
Very often we focus on our abilities or our lack of ability.
很多时候呢，我们都专注在于我们的无能。
Remember that first man, the paralyzed man.
记得第一个人他瘫痪了吗？
Jesus said, "Would you like to be healed?"
耶稣就问他，你想痊愈吗？
He said, "I cannot be healed. I can't make it to the water." Blah blah blah.
他是我，他就很多借口说我没有办法痊愈，我去不到水池里面。
What happened right there?
当时发生什么事?
He has resigned himself to his fate already. You know?
他认命了，他没有办法得救了。
He said he has settled there already.
他已经安于现状了。
So when Jesus said, "We'd like to be healed."
所以当耶稣问他，你愿意得医治的时候，痊愈的，他说什么？
He said, "I cannot."
他说我不可以。
I cannot make it to the
water. 我没办法去到水池里。
Even if I get to the water, too late.
我去到水池，我也不是第一个。
He was focusing on his abilities.
其实他专注在他自己的无能。
But notice something.
可是你要注意到一个东西。
My point here today is not about ability.
今天我说的并不是能力啊。
I'm talking about authority.
我要说的是权柄。
That God has given us authority.
上帝赐给了我们权柄。
You see, the truth is this, 啊。
我要让大家知道。
We don't have the ability, you know.
我们没有能力的。
We all 不行的哎。
我们是不行的。
We cannot win.
我们真的不可以。
You talk about going beyond.
你说我们要超越吗？
Do we have the ability to overcome our sin?
我们真的有能力能超越，能克服我们的罪吗？
Do we have the ability to overcome our weaknesses?
我们有办法克服我们的软弱吗？
Do we have the ability to overcome our struggles?
我们有能力来克服我们的挣扎吗？
I'll tell you right now, we don't.
我要告诉你，没有能力。
When you understand that you don't have the ability, then you don't have to focus on it anymore. You know?
当你知道你无能为力的时候，你就不用再去想了。
Because if you come back to Ephesians 3:20,
因为当你回到以弗所书第三章第二十节的时候
，Let's look at the first line there.
我们看看第一句啊，上帝的能力运行在我们里面。
It says it is God's ability.
他说是上帝的能力。
God is the one who is able.
上帝是有能力的那一位。
We are unable.
我们是无能为力。
But God is able.
可是上帝大有能力。
And we have the authority to call on God's ability.
我们有那个权柄可以呼召要求神的能力。
See, we need to stop focusing on ability.
我们不要再专注于我们的能力了。
God constantly teaches us about authority.
因为上帝教导我们的是权柄。
Let's look at John 14.
我们看一看约翰福音第十四章第十二节到十四节。我实实在在的告诉你们，我所做的事，信我的人也要做，而且要做更大的事，因为我要回到父那里去。你们奉我的名，无论求什么，我必允许，好让父在子身上得到荣耀。你们若奉我的名向我求什么，我必应允。
Hey, those are powerful words there.
哇，这几个字真的很大有能力的。
All of us here, I mean, unless you're a visitor, but the rest of us here in FCBC, you're Christians, right?
我们大部分的人在这里都是基督徒吧？
You pray, right?
祷告有没有？
How do we end our prayers?
祷告结束的时候讲什么？在阿
In Jesus' name.
在阿门之前，奉耶稣的名。
We don't say in my name.
不是奉宝亮的名。
In the name of FCBC.
不是奉教会的名。
In the name of my strength.
奉我妈的名
，We don't say any of these things.
我们不这样说的
，Because we don't have the ability.
因为我们没有这些能力。
We are calling based on authority.
我们的求是以那个权柄的名
，In Jesus' name.
耶稣就是权柄，奉耶稣的名。
See, if you and I have ability,
如果你跟我有能力的话
，Then we don't need to pray, you know.
我们不需要祷告了。
So imagine,
你试想一下。
Let's say I got this ability.
打个比方说，我有这个大能。
Let's say I can heal any sickness just by touching someone.
我只要拍拍你的肩膀，你就可以痊愈。
Then do I need to pray anymore?
那我还需要祷告吗
？No need, what?
你来向我祷告。
You're sick,
你生病啊
？Okay, yeah.
哇，很痛啊！你不舒服吗 ？Okay 了。
I can do that.
就可以这样做了。
But we cannot, right?
可是我们不可以。
In fact, when someone is sick, we go and pray.
有时候有人祷告，有人生病了，我们去祷告的话。
No, we pray like mad.
我们拼命的祷告。
Why we pray like mad?
为什么拼命的祷告
？Because we know we got no power.
因为我们知道我们是无能为力的。
But we pray and we call upon the name of Jesus.
可是我们祷告，我们呼求耶稣的名。
See, that is the difference between authority and ability.
所以权柄和能力就是这个区别所在。
Let me explain this a little bit further.
我再给大家详细的解释一下。
The difference between ability and authority.
能力和权柄的区别。
Here's one example of ability.
有啊，能力的一个例子是什么呢？
Ability can take the form of this man called Edward Hall.
啊，这个能力呢，就可以用一个人的经历来描述，他叫爱德华。
This is a 32-year-old man.
32岁，跟宝亮牧师跟你一样。
我33岁。
你老了啊。这个人32岁，他是一个强人。
He holds the world record for the heaviest deadlift.
他持有世界纪录，能够举起的那个重量。
So what he's doing there is called a deadlift.
他所做的这个呢，就是在举重。
His record.
他的记录呢
？Is 500 kg.
是500公斤。一千斤
，half a ton 呢、啊？
就是半吨呢、啊。
所以 look at that，
你看着他。
This is called ability。
这个叫做能力。
He trained。
他去训练了。
Uses his strength。
他使用他的力量。
He can lift. He lifts it。
他就能够举起五百公斤。
This ability。
这是能力。
What is authority？
权柄是什么呢
？Authority is a policeman。
权柄就是一个交通警察。
Who can stop a 3-ton truck？
他能够停止一辆大量的三吨大重的一个货车。
Just by doing this，
他只是这样做才。
That's the difference between ability and authority。
能力和权柄的区别就在于此。
We don't have the ability。
我们没有那个能力。
But we have the authority to call upon the name of Jesus。
可是我们有权柄，我们可以呼求耶稣的名。
You know who understood this the best in the Bible?
你知道圣经里面谁最了解这两件事情吗
？David，
就是大卫。
When David had to confront Goliath，
当大卫要去面对哥利亚的时候
，Let's look at 1 Samuel chapter 17 verse 4 to 11。
我们看一下这个撒母耳记上第十七章第四节到第十一节。非利士营中有个名叫哥利亚的巨人出来讨战，他来自加特，身高三米，头戴铜盔。身穿重达57公斤的这个盔甲，腿上呢是有一个铜护膝，然后呢他的肩呢是背着铜戟，戟柄粗如制布机的轴，铁戟头重7公斤，有卫士拿着他的盾牌走在前面，他挑战以色列人说，你们为什么列阵打仗呢？我是非利士人，你们是扫罗的仆人，你们选一个人下来跟我一比高下。第九节，如果他打得过我，将我杀了，我们就做你们的奴隶；但如果我战胜他，把他杀了，你们就要做我们的奴隶，服侍我们。我今天向以色列军队骂阵，你们找一个人出来跟我比个高下吧。十一节，扫罗和所有以色列人听了非利士人的这些话，都吓得惊恐不已。
The last verse 啊，
最后一句。
They were terrified.
他们都吓得惊恐不已。
Actually, if you read a few verses down,
如果你在下面读多两三句的话，
you know how long they were terrified?
你知道他们那时的惧怕是多久吗？
40 days.
40日。
40 days, Goliath got up every day.
40天，哥利亚早晨起来，每天
walk out towards them.
就走向以色列人。
Insult the Israelites, make fun of them.
侮辱他们，嘲笑他们。
And for 40 days, all of them are so terrified.
四十天不停不休的使每个人吓到屁股尿流。
Why?
为什么？
Because they were only focused on ability or their lack of ability.
因为他们只想到他们的无能为力。
They said, "Wow, this guy he knows how to fight, you know."
哇，这个人三米高，很会打仗。
He's a giant. He's so big. He's so strong.
他是巨人，他又高又大又壮的。
No way we can win him.
没办法赢他的。
So they were so terrified.
所以他们充满惧怕。
Because all they looked at was ability.
因为他们所能看到的就只是能力的局限。
Then comes along this young man.
然后就来了一个年轻人，名叫大卫。
Verse 32.
我们看一下啊，32节。大卫对扫罗说：“大家不要因这个非利士人而丧胆，让仆人去战他。”扫罗说，你不能去，你年纪还小，他却是一个久经沙场的战士。
Oh, you see, they were all terrified, you know.
他们都是惊恐不已。
And these were all soldiers, you know.
然后这些全部都是受过训的一些军士。
Then this small boy, this young man comes up.
然后这个年轻人叫大卫。
这个臭小子。
臭小子。
This small boy comes up.
他就来到他们的面前。
And he tells, I like the English translation, you know.
其实英文版讲得很好。
He said this to Saul.
他对扫罗说
：“Don't worry about this Philistine。”
他其实他的直译呢，就是你们不要担心这个非利士人
了。He looked to Saul and said, "My God."
他跟扫罗说：“Mo gang 啊。
”He said, "I go and settle."
让我来去解决。
And when he said that,
当他这么说的时候
what did Saul say to him?
扫罗怎么回他呢
How can you fight him?
他说你怎么能去战他呢
You're only a boy.
你年纪还小还是小朋友
This guy has been a fighter since he was a boy.
这个是久经沙场的一个战士屡战屡胜的
Why did he say that?
为什么这么说呢
Again, he was focused on ability.
同样的他只看见他肉眼能看见的能力
Then you go on and read verses 41 to 45.
然后我们接下来就看下来第41节到45节。歌利亚也迎着大卫走来，卫士拿着他的盾牌走在前面。歌利亚看见大卫是一个面色红润、相貌英俊的少年，就藐视他。他对大卫说：“你拿着棍子来战我，难道我是一条狗吗？”啊，有幽默啊！他就凭自己的神名咒诅大卫，又说：“你过来，我要把你的肉。”丢给天上的飞禽和地上的走兽大卫答道你是靠刀枪剑戟来攻击我我是靠万军之耶和华的名就是你所藐视的以色列军队的上帝来迎阵你
This is probably one of my favorite passages in scripture
这也很可能就是我经文里面最喜欢读的一段话语
Everyone was focused on ability
每个人都在想着啊，那个能力的局限。
But David was the only one who focused on authority.
可是大卫他的专注在哪里呢？在于上帝的权柄。
He did not say this, you know.
他并没有说。
He didn't say you come against me with sword and spear and javelin.
他并没有说你拿着刀枪剑戟来对击我。
But Goliath, I tell you 啊。
可是哥利亚，我跟你讲啊。
I got a sling, you know.
我有一个弹弓。
I got rocks, you know.
我有石块。
I know how to use it, you know.
我知道怎么用。
He didn't say that.
他并没有这么说。
He didn't say, "Oh, you come against me with sword and spear and javelin."
他并没有说你拿着刀枪剑戟来对着我。
Hey, but as a shepherd, I killed lion before, you know.
可是我是牧羊人，我杀过狮子。
I killed those wolves that tried to attack the sheep, you know.
我杀过要攻击我的羊的那个狼。
He didn't say anything about this.
他什么都没有说。
Nothing about ability.
他并没有夸耀自己的能力有多大。
What did he say?
他说什么
？You come against me with sword and spear and javelin.
你拿着刀枪剑戟来对着我。
I come against you in the name of the Lord God Almighty.
我是靠着万军之耶和华的名来迎战你的
That is authority
这个就是权柄
What did David do?
大卫做了什么呢
David basically walked up to Goliath
他基本上来到哥利亚的面前
And just like the policeman
然后就犹如那个警察所做的
I want to submit this to you now
好我要跟大家建议一下
David I don't believe that David had the ability to defeat Goliath
我其实真的是相信大卫没有那个能力去击垮哥利亚的。
You compare their size,
你拿他们的身高，他们身量来比较。
When Goliath actually saw David,
当哥利亚看到大卫的时候
，Goliath said this, "Why you send a stick to fight me?"
哥利亚竟然问了你拿了这你带了一只你派了一只小棍子来跟我打吗
？Because he looked like a stick compared to Goliath.
因为对于哥利亚来说，大卫就好像一只棍子而已。
Then you read it,
然后你再读。
David put the stone in the sling.
然后呢，这个大卫呢就把石块放在一个弹弓。
He take the thing, he throw the rock.
他就往前抛。
First rock hit Goliath in the head, and Goliath died already.
第一块石头打中了这里，哥利亚的这里，然后哥利亚就死了。
Hey, I ask you 啊。
我问你啊。
Life got so 抬高啊？
生命有那么的侥幸的吗
？So lucky 啊？
就那么的幸运的吗
？It's not luck.
这个并不是侥幸。
It's authority.
这是权柄。
God was on his side.
上帝是站在他的那一边的。
It was God's ability, not David's ability.
是上帝的能力，而不是我们自己的能力。
See, today, church, we need to understand this.
今天教会我们必须理解。
That we have position.
我们有那个身份。
We have position to, and because we have position, we have authority.
就因为我们有那个身份，所以我们有那个权柄。
If you are a son of a king of kings,
如果你是万王之王的儿子
，That means you are prince, right?
也就是说你是王子啦。
If you are a daughter of the king of kings,
如果你是万王之王的女儿
，You are a princess, what?
你就是小公主。
What does 1 John chapter 4 verse 4 say?
这个约翰一书第四章第四节告诉我们。孩子们，你们属于上帝，你们已经胜过了那些假先知，因为在你们里面的圣灵比在世上运行的邪灵更有能力。
You look at this passage for a while.
我们看一下这段经文。
A few interesting things here.
啊，有一些亮点要注意一下。
First, you are called children.
首先，他说孩子们。
Secondly.
第二。
It says the one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world.
他说在你里面的圣灵比在世上的邪灵更有能力。
It didn't say that you are greater than the one who is in the world.
他并没有说你比邪灵更有能力。
The one who is in you is greater.
而是说在你里面的圣灵更有能力。
Today,
今天
we need to learn to ask God.
我们今天要学习到去寻求神。
And I like how it starts. It says children. You know?
我喜欢他的开头，他说孩子们。
You know, children have a certain way of asking.
你知道孩子们跟家长要东西、求东西是一个有一个方法的。
Especially young children.
尤其是小朋友们。
You know, I give this example.
哦，我给你一个例子啊。
If I need some money now, as a grown up, if I need some money,
我现在已经是成人了，33岁。然后呢，我需要钱。
If I talk to my father,
如果我去找我爸爸，然后说，
you know, I'll be a bit 排斥啊，
我就觉得很不好意思了。
Hey, Dad,
哎爸，
I need a bit money 啊，
我需要点钱了。
You know,
我的投资不好了啊。
You say like that.
啊，我可能会这样说话。
But have you seen small children before?
你有看过小朋友三岁、四岁、五岁的？
How do small children ask their parents for?
他们是怎么样跟爸爸妈妈要东西、要钱的呢？
They walk to the father.
他们走到爸爸前面，理直气壮的。爸，不要走，不要走，爸，回来，爸。
Even teenagers, right?
就算是青少年吧，十来岁。
爸 ，I need $10 啊。
爸，我需要10块钱。
You just ask, right?
你就直接跟他要了。
Because it's something about children, you know.
因为孩子们有一个不一样的东西。
They have this full trust.
他们是完全的信靠的。
That the father will give us.
父亲会给的。
And today.
而今天
，We need to come back to this.
我们必须回到这个初心。
You must know this position as children of God.
你要知道身为神的孩子的这个身份。
When we know our position,
当我们知道我们的身份是什么的时候
authority,
当我知道我们有这个权柄的时候
when we know we have access to God,
当我知道我们可以亲近神的时候
then we are going to go beyond.
那我们就可以超越极限了
So today,
今天
What is it that enables us to go beyond?
是什么能够帮助我们超越极限呢
Number one,
第一
Accessibility to God.
神为我们打开大门
He grants us power because we have access to Him.
他赐给我们能力因为我们亲近他
Number two,
第二
We have authority from God.
神赋予我们权柄
and because He has given us position.
因为他赐给我们身份
Today,
今天
in this new season,
在这个新的季节、新的一年
we must learn to ask.
我们必须要学习去寻求、去要求、去苦求
You know, last year God placed a burden upon my heart.
去年上帝给了我一个负担，心里面
and the burden was this.
而心里面的这负担是什么呢？
That I believe that we as a church,
相信就是我们身为教会
we have forgotten how to ask.
我们已经忘记了如何去求上帝
I remember it was actually during the celebration of hope period.
我记得那个时候就是在希望与你有约的那段时间
There were different prayer meetings leading up to the event.
之前呢已经有好也在教会在新加坡的不同地点已经有不同的祷告会
And I was anchoring one of those prayer meetings here at TC.
而当时我在出外中心在带着其中一个祷告会
I remember I was praying.
我记得那时候在祷告
And suddenly something in my heart just made me stop, you know.
然后突然间有一件事情就让我停止带领了
stop everybody from praying.
然后我就停止了每个人在祷告我叫他们停
And I asked this question.
我就问了大家一个问题
I said this.
我说
Church, do we believe that Singapore can be saved?
教会我们相不相信新加坡可以得救
Because if we don't believe, then what are we even praying for?
如果我们不相信的话那我们在这里祷告什么呀
Then this prayer is nothing but going through the motion.
那这个祷告呢不就是一个仪式罢了没有什么意义的
Do we actually believe?
我们真的相信吗
I know people say, oh, but Pastor, you know, Singapore is a multi-racial, different religions, everything in Singapore.
当然有人会说，哎呀，牧师啊，新加坡是多元种族、多元宗教。我明白。
But the question is, do you actually believe?
可是我想问的是，你真的相信吗
？That's the underlying thing here.
那个是最初的那个启发点。
I remember one song we used to sing.
我记得我们喜欢唱的一首歌。
This one line of song that says this.
有一首歌，那是它的歌词是这样唱的。
We believe with all our hearts that this land will be saved.
我们全心深信这片土地会得救。
In fact, if you know the next line, it says, "In the name of Jesus Christ."
我们如果你记得它下一段歌词的话，就是奉耶稣的名，你凭信心踏出。
That's authority right there.
这是权柄。
But remember, the church we had this desire to ask.
我记得当我们的教会是有这个欲望要去。求神的
And we ask big.
而我们会寻求求主赐给我们更大的事情
Just a quick question
我要问一个问题
How many of you here and over at Gateway Theatre You've been in FCBC for more than 15 years Can I see your hand?
在我们教会多过15年的在这里在教会请举手
More than 15
多过15年在我们教会的
Gateway 有什么
教会剧院
Okay, I see your hands again
我看到你们的手好放下来
All those who lift up your hands
举过手的
Y'all remember this thing called Vision 2001
你们记得当时我们有一个意象叫做2001意象吗？
We believe in that in the year 2001 there will be this mighty harvest.
我们那时候相信2001年我们会有一个大收割。
Remember what? We pray like mad. We work like mad.
我们那时拼命的祷告，拼命的服侍，拼命的工作。
My dad and the Love Singapore pastors put some videos together.
我记得当时我的父亲和很多爱新加坡的牧师们呢，就拍了一部这个视频。
There's one video I never forgot.
有一个视频我是不会忘记的。
It was my dad.
是我父亲。
Well, then it's back in the 90s.
当时是90年代末的时候，眼镜还是很大的框。
I remember this scene was he walked into an MRT train.
我记得那一幕呢，就是一个视觉特效，我父亲走进地铁。
He walked in the train. He looked at everybody.
他看见每一个人。
He said, "Praise the Lord."
他说赞美主。
And everybody shouted, "Hallelujah."
然后在地铁里面，每个人就喊 "Hallelujah."
I mean, you think about it, quite funny, the video.
你是想一下，还挺老土的呢。
But yeah, you think about it.
可是你试想一下。
That's faith right there, you know.
其实这就是信心啊。
That we want to believe that we will see that day.
我们相信我们会看到这一天。
And I remember that this church was defined by a people who asked big of God.
而我记得我们的教会当时是那么的突出，是因为我们有一群人，我们愿意相信神会成就更大的事。
We said, God, I believe my whole workplace can be saved.
你说我主啊，我相信我的工作职场会每个人都得救。
We had people who believed that whole HDB flat can be.
我们当时的会友相信我们整个 HDB 整个主屋大楼都会全部信主。
You know, we used to have church members.
当时我们有会友。
They would come to the pastor.
他们会来到牧师那边。
And say, Pastor, which area?In Singapore got no cell group yet.
他会来问牧师，然后牧师啊，新加坡的哪一个主屋大楼没有小组的
？Okay, when we get married, we will buy a house there.
我跟我女朋友结婚的时候，我们
去到
那一栋楼，我们去买一间房子。
Because we want to be there, we want to see the entire neighborhood.
因为我们要开一个小组，我们要看见那整个邻里区认识主。为什么他们这样做呢？并不是因为我们很骄傲，以为我们很厉害。
But we dare to ask God.
而是因为我们有勇气去寻求神。
And I think somehow we've lost that.
我们失去了这些吗？
And church, we need to come back to that.
而教会，我们要回到起初的心。
And I know this is the word of God.
而我知道这是神要赐给我们的话语。
I know some of us, I know I talk about Vision 2001.
我知道我们曾经提过有2001的意象。
And maybe some people don't really like that, I bring it up.
可能有些人听了就觉得，哎，你干嘛要提这件事呢？
Because it pretty much was a flop.
因为当时这个意象是失败的。
There was a lot of disappointment, a lot of pain.
有很多失望，有很多痛苦。
But you know what? I know this is a new season.
可是你知道吗？我深信这是新的季节。
God has given me signs and signs again. This is the word for this season.
上帝给了我很多启示，让我相信这是神要给我们的话语。
A few months ago,
几个月前
，God already gave me this word.
上帝已经给了我这段话语了。
I went to talk to Pastor Eugene Siao.
我去找萧牧师，然后跟他说话了。
And he shared with me what God placed on his heart.
然后他就跟我分享了上帝在他心里面摆了一些什么东西。
Especially in the area of Touch International.
尤其是触爱国际事工。
And he said God gave him this word.
而他说上帝给了他一段话。
Psalm 2 verse 8.
也就是在诗篇第二章第八节，他说：“你求我。”我就将列国赐你为基业，将地级赐你为田产。
The moment he shared that with me, I said, "This is the word."
他跟我分享了这段话语的那一刻，我就知道就是这段话语。
That God is telling us to ask of Him.
上帝在告诉我们，我们要去求他。
You know the Bible is so beautiful, you know.
圣经是每一个话语，每一个词都是很美丽的。
The Scripture don't just tell us of a God who is powerful and can do everything, you know.
经文不单单是告诉我们，我们有一个伟大有能力的神。
But He is a God who invites us to partnership.
他也是邀请我们与他一起同工的神。
He says, "Ask of me, and I'll give you."
他说：“你们求我，我就赐给你。”
If you ask for me, I will do it for you.
你求我的话，我就一定会为你而成就大事。
You must just ask.
你就是要问。
Today, let's be a people who dare to ask.
今天我们要成为一个愿意去求上帝的子民。
Towards the end of 2019,
2019年年底的时候，
there was something that was happening in the church scene.
在教会里面呢，有一件事情发生了。
Not our church.
不是我们教会。
But it caused a lot of disagreement, I would say.
可是呢，有许多教牧同工不同教会有一些不同意的一些方面。
I'm talking about what happened at Bethel Church.
而那时候所发生的呢，就是在这个教会。叫做伯特利教会，在加州，在美国的加州。
And if you're familiar with it,
如果你听过这个故事的话
，the daughter of one of the couples, the worship leading couple,
其中一个敬拜牧师的女儿去世了。
for no reason she passed away.
她没有什么原因她去世了。
But even though she passed away, they were believing for a miracle.
就算她去世了，可是教会的人呢，相信会有奇迹。
They were praying for resurrection.
他们祷告她会复活起来。
And this caused this sparked a lot of controversy.
这就引起了许多争议。
People, there are a lot of people supportive, there are a lot of people critical about it.
很多人支持祷告复活，然而也有很多人去很多的批评。
And honestly, I can understand both sides.
说真的，我两方面我都能理解。
But this is my approach to this.
可是这是我会怎么去接触这个事情。
I tell myself I cannot form a proper conclusion.
我告诉自己，我没有办法有一个确切的结论。
You know why?
你知道为什么吗？
Because I'm not there.
因为我没有身在其境。
I don't know them personally.
我没有亲自的认识他们。
Everything I read about is online, is through a third party or fourth party.
我所知道，我所学习到都是在网上读到的，有第三或者第四个平台的。
And now everything online is so politicized. Different people have their own opinions.
然后现在又有什么假新闻呢、啊？又有政治取向，
so、said,
什么新闻都是可信的。
So、said,
所以我就觉得我不能够有一个确切的结论。
Said,
可是我能够做的什么是最好的呢
？I reflect on my own life.
我要回顾一下，反思一下我自己的生命。
So、as I reflect on my own life.
当我在反思我自己的生命的时候，
I'll tell you this.
我要告诉你。
This, I've been a pastor for 10 years in our church.
我当了十年的牧师在这教会。
In my 10 years of being a pastor.
在我当牧师的这十年里面。
I've never seen a resurrection.
我从来没有看过人因祷告而复活的。
Never seen it.
从来没见过。
Do I believe God can raise the dead?
我相信上帝可以将人死里复活。我相信。
But I've never seen it.
可是我从未见过。
You know why I never seen it?
你知道为什么没见过吗
？I'll tell you right now.
我现在告诉你。
Because I've never prayed for it before.
因为我没有祷告过，我没有求过。
That's it.
就是这样。
If you go for spiritual warfare, we are not talking about the gifts of the Holy Spirit.
如果你去参加属灵征战的这个课程的话，然后你学到圣灵的果子。
We talk about praying for healing.
我们说到要祷告医治。
You know what? You will never experience the healing power of God if you never prayed for someone to be healed before.
如果你从未为这一个人的疾病而祷告医治的话，你是不会经历到医治的。
Pastor Caesar always says this.
凯撒牧师经常说
If you want to see something you've never seen before, you got to do something you've never done before.
如果你要看见你从未看见过的东西，你必须要做你从未做过的事。
You know Reinhard Bonnke, right?
你知道布永康吗
？He passed on recently.
他最近去世了，79岁。
A while back, they had an interview on him.
可是之前呢，他们有访问过他。
He prays a lot for healing.
他赞美主，他相信主会赐医治。
And someone once asked him.
有人问过他。
Say evangelist Reinhard Bonnke.
他说啊，布永康布道家。
If you pray for someone,
如果你为一个人祷告
，and there's no healing,
而他没有被医治的话呢
，what do you do 啊？
你会怎么办
？He said this.
他说
，I pray for the next person.
我就为下一个人祷告。
If the next person doesn't get healed,
如果下一个人还没有得到医治的话
，then I pray for the next person.
那我再为下一个人祷告。再接着第四个、第五个、第六个，
and the next.
接下来继续祷告。
If I pray for 100 people,
如果我为100个人祷告医治，
and only one person gets healed,
而只有一个人得救，
I will celebrate.
我会庆祝。
If I pray for 100 people,
如果我为100个人祷告，
and nobody gets healed,
而没有人得到医治，
I will continue to pray
我会继续的不止的祷告。
So I'll teach you something.
我要教导大家。
The Bible says this.
圣经说
In James chapter 4 verses 2 to 3.
在雅各书第四章第二节到第三节说，你们得不着，是因为你们不求；你们求也得不着，是因为你们妄求，要浪费在你们的宴乐中。
It says that there are two reasons why we don't receive.
我们没有得着有两大原因。
One reason is that we ask with the wrong motive.
第一呢，是因为我们求的目的错了。
Number two.
第二。
You don't receive because you don't ask.
你得不着，因为你都没有求。
If you never ask, then how are you going to receive?
如果你不求，你怎么会得到呢
？You know, can you just imagine if your friend said this to you?
如果你朋友跟你说
，one day your friend very angry.
有一天你朋友很生气
，blackface you forever.
脸黑黑。
Okay, then he asks, why are you so upset?
然后你就问他，你为什么那么生气呀
？You never give me this thing.
你没有给我这个东西咯。
How I know you want this thing?
你都没讲，我怎么知道
？You never asked me before.
你都没问过我。
You see, the Bible says this: you have not because you ask not.
圣经就是因为这里教导我们说，你们得不着，因为你们没求。
Today is time for us to ask.
今天我们要学习去求。
Church, FCBC is meant to go beyond.
教会，我们这个坚信进行教会的旨意，上帝给我们的旨意就是我们要去超越极限。
Touch community services exist because we say we must go beyond the four walls of the church.
我们有出外社会服务的这个存在，是因为我们相信教会要超越这四面墙。
Touch international exist because we say we must go beyond the borders of Singapore.
我们相信出爱国际事工的存在，是因为我们相信我们要去到万国，我们要超越新加坡。
Gateway Entertainment, Gateway Theater exists because we must go beyond the regular way of bringing the gospel to people.
嘉伟传媒和嘉伟剧院的存在，是因为我们相信我们把娱乐带给大家要超越只是一个剧院。
But for us to go beyond, it requires us to ask of God.
可是如果我们要超越极限的话，我们需要学习去寻求神。
And today it's time to ask.
而今天是时候要寻求神。
You know, as I close off, I wrote down a few notes here.
当我做一个总结，在准备的时候，我写了几段话。
Why we don't ask?
为什么我们不会去求神？
Well, sometimes we don't ask because we actually believe in ourselves more than God.
有时候我们不会去求上帝，因为我们信自己多过信上帝。
See, if you don't ask someone for help, it's because you feel that you can do it already.
如果你不去向人求助的话，那是因为你相信你自己就可以搞得定。
But today I say this.
今天我要说。
You have no ability.
你搞不定。
So you must ask God.
所以你要去求上帝。
The second reason why we don't ask.
我们不去寻求神的第二个原因。
Is because we focus on our own inability instead of God's ability.
是因为我们关注自己的无能，而漠视上帝的大能。
We're like that paralyzed man.
就有如那个瘫痪的人。
God says, "Do you want to be healed?"
上帝问他，你要得到医治吗？
I cannot lah.
哎呀，没办法啦，不可以啦。
Sometimes we say, "We do that, right?"
我们会这样说的。
We don't ask big because we think cannot.
我们不敢去问，是因为我们不可以。
We don't dare to ask God for the multitudes.
我们不敢求上帝赐给我万民。
We say, "Wow, God, I can't even get my own life in order. How to lead people?"
因为你想，哎呀，上帝啊，我的生命都无能为力了，你还要我求得到万民啊？
I cannot lah, I cannot.
哎呀，我不可以了。
You don't focus on inability, you know.
千万不要关注在你自己的无能。
Yesterday I was at the youth service.
昨天我在那个青少年的聚会。
To the youth,
我也分享了话语。
I say, hey, all of you,
我就问了大家，哎，大家
，Do you all dare to believe that someone among here you can be the next senior pastor of this church? You know,
你们相不相信在座的年轻人里面，你们其中一位会成为我们教会的下一个主任牧师，或者别教会的主任牧师
？Then you look each other.
他们就彼此就看了一下。
Cannot.
不可能啦。
I say, hey, why do you write yourself off?
我就说，为什么你就这么不确定自己呢？
Hey, if I go back in time,
如果我时光倒流的话，
and I look at myself as a kid,
而我看着我小时候的那个样子，
I know many of you in church have seen me grow up in this church.
我知道在这里刚才举手15年以上都看过我在教会成长。
You all saw me last time, you cannot mention, this is a senior pastor.
你们看到我以前那个样子，那个模样，你会想，哈，主任牧师，哈。
Last time when my dad preached,
以前当我父亲在台上讲道的时候，
when I come to church,
我来教会，
I come to church and I bring a lot of toys.
我来教会，我一包的东西，一个包包里面都是玩具。
People reading Bible, I'm on the pew, I got cars.
人家在读圣经，我就玩着跑车。
My dad preaching,
我父亲在讲道。
I take out toy guns, you know.
我拿出玩具枪
，and I shoot him.
然后我就射他 ，pew pew pew 的。
Last night when I telling this story,
以前我讲这故事的时候
，some people already know what I'm saying, you know.
有些人已经知道了。
Because they saw me doing this.
因为他们当时在场看到我在 pew 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 我爸爸。
There was one time.
那时候
my dad was preaching.
我父亲在讲道。
You know what I was doing?
你知道我在干嘛吗？
I was lying on the floor.
我躺在地上。
I take two toy guns.
我拿了两个玩具枪。
I aim at my father.
我瞄准我父亲。
Then last time you know you watch all those action movies.
然后你以前记得那些动作片电影。
They will roll on the floor.
他们会在地上滚来滚去。
I roll from this side to this side, then this side back to this side.
我从这一边滚到那边，然后我又滚回去。
If I look at that person,
如果我看着那个人的话，
你算 senior pastor 啊？
以后的主任牧师啊！
笑料啊！
哇，假烂啊！
I remember my father saw until he buay tahan, he scold me.
我知道我在台上的父亲，他看到他受不了，他骂我。
He stopped preaching, you know.
他暂时停了讲道。
He said, Daniel, can you stop it? You're very distracting.
他说宝亮，你别再滚啦。
Then I cry.
然后我就哭。
I went home, I tell my mother.
我回家告诉妈妈。
Then she scold my father.
然后妈妈骂我爸爸。
What was the point I'm making here?
我想说什么？
Don't look at the inability.
千万不要看到那个无能为力的那个你。
Because if you only focus on inability, right?
因为如果你只专注你的无能的话，
you will never go beyond.
你是无法超越极限的。
It is time to go beyond.
是时候要超越了。
The third reason why we don't ask.
我们不敢问、不敢求的第三个原因，
is because we're afraid of disappointment.
是因为我们害怕失望。
Some of us we've experienced enough disappointment.
我们当中有很多人都经历过失望。
You know,Sometimes that's why we don't ask, you know.
所以我们不敢问咯。
If I don't ask, I'll never be disappointed.
如果我不问的话，我就不会失望啊。
If it's my birthday,
如果是我生日
，and I don't expect anybody to give me present,
而我不奢望任何人送我礼物
，then when I never receive present, I'm not disappointed.
所以当我没有收到礼物的时候，就不会失望咯。
This some people do that.
有些人的确是这样。
But can I say this?
可是我想说
，that's a very sad way to live life.
这样子过生活挺伤心的。
Let's not live life like that.
我们千万不要这样子过活好吗
？Let's be like Reinhard Bonnke.
我们就好像不永康这样。
You face disappointment.
你面对了失望
，try again.
你再试
，try again.
再尝试。
Will you try? Will there be failures?
当你在尝试会有失败吗？继续会有失败。
But if you never try, you will never ever succeed.
可是如果你永不尝试，你就永不会成功。
So keep trying.
所以你要继续的尝试。
Come back and ask God again.
回到神的面前去寻求他。
And the last thing I want to share here today.
而我要说的最后一个为什么
？Sometimes we don't ask because we don't know we can ask.
有时候我们不去问、不去求，是因为我们不知道我们可以求神帮助。
We don't realize that God is asking us to ask Him.
其实上帝在叫我们去问他，去求他。
You look through scripture.
你看经文。
What does God say?
上帝说什么
？Come to me.
你们来到我这里。
Ask me.
你们求我。
I will give it to you.
我会赐给你。
I will do it for you.
我会为你而成就大事。
You have not because you ask not.
你没有得着，是因为你没有求。
Church, as we enter into this new season.
教会啊，当我们进入这个新的季节。
It's time to ask God.
我们是时候要去寻求上帝了。
Ask big.
你们要敢敢的去问求神。
I believe that there are people here. You had a dream.
我相信在座有人曾经有过一个梦。
You asked God for something before.
你求主赐给你一些东西。
But you stopped asking for it.
可是你停止了，不再问了。
God says, ask again.
今天上帝跟你说，你再来问我吧。
Today, God is just like he's doing what Jesus did.
今天上帝他在做耶稣当时所做的。
He's asking us, what do you want me to do for you?
他是在问我们，你要我为你做什么？
Today is time to ask.
今天我们是时候开问开求了。
I believe this church is going to go to beyond to infinity and beyond.
我相信这个教会一定能够超越极限。
But it will only go there if we all ask.
我们能够超越极限，是因为我们问了，我们求了。
Don't ever settle wherever you are.
千万不要求其次。
Go beyond.
要超越。
Go beyond that situation.
要超越你的环境。
And I'll say this right now.
而我要告诉你。
All the leaders here.
对所有的领袖。
I'm not going to let you settle.
我不会让你安于现状。
I will not let anyone here settle.
我不会让在座任何人安于现状。而所有的领袖。
I will not let you let any member of the church settle.
我不会让你的组员安于现状。
Because this church is going to go beyond.
因为这个教会要超越。
We are going to go to that place that God has called us to be.
我们要去到上帝带我们去的应许之地。
And I'm not going to be satisfied to be lost in the wilderness for 40 years.
我不会满足于我们就在这个旷野当中迷失。
Because God did not call us to live in the wilderness.
因为上帝的呼召并不是叫我们在旷野中生活。
God has called us to be in that promised land.
上帝叫我们是去应许之地。
And I will not settle for anything less.
而我不会就安心于上帝不赐给我们的东西。
And I refuse to let this church settle for anything
less. 而我不愿这教会安于现状，求其次。
So this is the word.
所以这是上帝给的话语。
Is for this season ahead.
就是为这来临的这个季节。
But I'm going to hold this word very importantly to me.
可是我会紧紧的抓住这段话语。
Because I believe this word is for my whole ministry.
因为我相信这段话语是给了我的整个事工。
And I'm not going to let go of it.
而我不会松手。
I'm going to ask God.
我会求上帝。
Because He is able.
因为他有能力。
Through the mighty power that is at work within us.
透过在我们里面的大能的圣灵。
To do infinitely more.
可以丰丰富富的去成就一切
what we can ever ask for.
超过我们所求所想的
so, church,
所以教会
ask
你们就要去求
I'm very excited
好我好激动啊
Let's all stand up right now
我们站起来好吗
Both here and over there at Gateway
在这边也在教会剧院
We're just going to close off with this worship song
我们要进入敬拜
If you're still being prayed for, continue to be prayed for
如果你正在接受祷告请继续
But the rest of us, let's lift up our hands
其余的人我们举起我们的双手
I want to speak this blessing over you.
我要宣告祝福在你们身上。
I declare that God's power is at work within you.
我宣告在你里面的圣灵大大的在你里面工作。
And He is able.
他有能力。
To do infinitely more than what you ask.
能丰丰富富的成就一切。
Today I speak strength and courage into each and every one
of you. 今天我宣告在你里面有力量有勇气。
That you will dare to ask God.
你会敢于去求上帝。
You will dream big.
你会为他做一个大的梦。
You will ask big.
你会寻求更多的。
And together as a family,
我们身为教会的一家人。
We will go beyond.
我们会超越。
We will go wherever God has called us to be.
上帝呼召我们去哪里，我们就去哪里。
And we will not settle for anything less.
我们不会最终退而求其次。
So Lord, today,
所以今天主啊，
we commit ourselves afresh to you.
我们重新的将自己恭敬的交入在你手中。
In this year ahead,
在这新的一年。
May this be a year that we see ourselves going beyond.
这是我们会超越的一年。
Then we will not settle.
我们不会安于现状。
But we'll see the new things that you have in store for us.
我们看见你主成就新的事。
So church, I speak this word over you right now.
所以教会啊，我宣告这个话语在你身上。
That God is in you.
上帝在你里面。
God is with you.
上帝与你同在。
You have access to Him.
你能够与他亲近，来到他面前。
You have authority that comes from Him.
你有他所赋予你的权柄。
So it's time to rise up as the children of God.
所以是时候兴起来了，神的孩子。
I bless you with this.
我祝福你们。
In the mighty name of Jesus.
奉耶稣基督的大能祷告。
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
God bless you and see you next week.
上帝祝福你们，我们下星期见。